Or I'd either have to put the phone up to my ear the whole time or put on speakerphone. I don't necessarily want to have a conversation with everybody in the room. It's true. Please don't. Think that would be greatly overrated.
Hello? Hello? Oh, yeah, but we can say, hold on.
Not really, but I'm sure I'll figure it out. I just got a relic. I don't know what it does, but
okay. Can you hear me? Okay.
I can.
Or even Dane, if you just enable the suppression, it might cut out your kids.
Alright, how's that?
Let me do push to talk as well.
Who's orange? What do I spend my gold on?
You just bury it once you get 600. Yeah. Oh, I've never been a dread pirate before.
I think I'm winning.
Yeah, I hate when they run away. I was surrounded by six ships. I couldn't move. I was going to the ports. I was going to the cities, and they surrounded me. Well, I went to one tavern and it gave me a relic, and I went to another tavern and it didn't do anything.
That's probably what happened.
Can you hear me now? Hey Hank, can you turn off your push to talk? There's a really annoying person behind you talking. You know, one of these times I'm actually going to get this naval supremacy achievement that just teases me every time. It's like, naval supremacy, 6 out of 12. It's achievement progress, so I don't know. I mean, it's just like, I think it's just, yeah, like while you're controlling a certain amount of squares in the ocean or something. I haven't been able to look it up, because every time I get a chance to look at it, my internet's actually down. I don't go for capturing other ships now unless there's really nobody else nearby, because I find that I always just capture one and then they die the next turn.
As long as I can not die. Do I go to those yellow places and then get the treasure there? Yeah, I see him. I'm going to do one of those right now.
You,
But I had
you
to
can also...
spend my turn repairing my boat.
You can also plunder your own buried treasure, and I haven't found that there's any negative impacts on that. But you still gain a bunch of points. Wow. So, like I said, no real big negative impacts. Also, Dane, something important to note, if you get the talent, the promotion for can move after attacking, your move can also be to heal after attacking. So if you're in shallow waters and you attack, and then you have that first promotion point in that, then you can also heal after you attack.
Oh, I got a boat. I mean, I got an extra boat. I captured a galleon. And somebody sunk it.
Yeah, okay. That's what I was saying before. I don't usually capture boats unless there's really no other boats nearby, because they always just die the next turn and then I lose a crew member.
Okay, so I visited a thing and it must have given me a treasure map, because I haven't really been paying attention to him.
Yeah, you get like 500 gold if you destroy the city.
Yeah, I am gonna die again. I can't get out. I'm stuck.
Sometimes they won't kill you all the way and run away too.
Do you see the picture I posted in Discord?
Ah, see, you're also getting attacked by the city, too, Dane.
I have to go to the ports, don't I?
But you also get attacked.
I got it. Yeah. Alright, what do I do with 10 gold every time a unit engages in combat? Every naval ship has the walk plank.
Just go find treasure.
Walk the plank can be used on any badly damaged enemy ship to sink the ship. In exchange for 3 movement and 5 combat strength for 5 turns.
That's what it was. You just weren't acting pirate enough.
I found plenty of cities my first go.
Yeah, there's...
No, I've got four up here with me in the top left corner. I'm definitely coming back for that and killing it. Lucky. What was that? I love when there's all these ships around that I can kill and ouch, ouch, ouch! I believe in you. Truce. Let's finish a game together before we start killing each other.
Can I finish a game, period?
The first time we played this, the second Mark saw me, he just took me out in one hit and then it was over and then it was done. I thought, well, this is fun. Oh, we can get the same relics. Yeah, like you got the one that's plus 10 strength to Buccaneers and Infamous Pirates, and I got it. That's
another quote. Yeah, there's Tortuga right here, and there's Porta Perry just to the, my west. I guess it's on the other side of the continent, though, so maybe not this way.
The can you guys hear me if I yeah, my push to talk isn't like holding down all the time. Okay. So what I was saying was I think the size of the map would be a bit more significant if you could change the number of turns, but since we're limited and forced to 60 turns, then yeah, making a big map doesn't, it just kind of makes it harder to kill because you can only have 4 pirates in the first place anyway. So you can become friends with cities as well, and they don't. Sorry, they don't attack you if you become friends with them. And you can become friends with them by, like, some people have abilities to, like, give gifts back. Yeah, so for example, when I was killing a pirate, when I was killing Blackbeard earlier, there was a galleon next to him, and I did the return home or whatever, and I gave it back to Spain. And now I'm. Okay.
Wait. The one had a patron.
Oh, what's my quest? Ah, yeah, okay, that's what you're saying, yeah, that's right. Yeah, you must be in a bad area. I'm just kind of rolling down the coast and grabbing cities. What are you buried in a city? Ah, okay, yeah. I was confused. You ain't got no crew, then you ain't nothing, son. No, I think I think the best relic is to add an additional move to all of your ships, because once they're promoted 3 ranks, then that's 3 moves per turn that they can do, plus then they can heal after they do that.
Is the only way to get crew visiting a tavern? Do I need a crew to get treasure? I think there's like a treasure map.
I really enjoy this scenario. Did you just say 7? Ah, that's why it's 2 Dread Pirates and their followers, yeah. Be right back. No, I'm back. Just embarking on a mission. Are you to you kill the Dread Pirate? Oh, that's a lot of points you just got.
Okay, so if there's a spot of land that's yellow, that means there's buried treasure in it.
Yeah, don't. So you can range attack, or you can do the one that looks like a meteor. Like barbarian camps and stuff.
It's on the coast, but it's not giving me a coastal raid option. Must not have enough. Okay, you said once I have 600, I should go bury my treasure somewhere. And what's this red octagonal thing?
Yeah, man, just wait till you get a crew. Just drop your one crew on the ground and go bury them. I would have a lot more. It's just that every ship I see right now, I have so many trade routes around me, and they're all Spain. They're all Spanish. Everything around me is Spanish. I can't attack it or pillage it or anything. But I don't have like treasure and stuff that, you know, it's giving me other things to do. So. Yeah, that's the best relic, definitely. Right. Now you have three attacks, and then now you can take out a city by yourself, because you can do three attacks, and then you can heal at the end as well. The worst relic is definitely the see enemies within 20 yards, 20 tiles of you. Yeah, well, you got this one in the bag. I mean, all you have to do is keep burying treasures every turn. And plus you're a hoarder, too, so you're getting an extra 10 points every treasure you bury, too. Oh, you have 3% interest? That's how you have so much money.
I want a treasure map. I want a crew. Can I only go to a tavern once? Oh, once every 10 turns?
Yeah. You always get a crew there, as long as there's a crew available.
Oh, okay. So that's little number two by my thing. Now I have two crew.
Oh, you got it. I couldn't think of the name. I was like, what's that name?
Trying to take out the Dread Pirate Roberts, but he keeps running away from me.
You're getting more gold than you can bury. First world problems.
Brackenons. No, but I did all right for, coming in halfway through.
Technically, he did die.
Listen, even the Buddhist monks know the first life doesn't count.
Well, let's push through the last four turns on this one. Oh, nice. Good thing I didn't say anything. Although, one thing I did was, I went and played a normal game after I played a bunch of Pirates games, and then I would move, and then not understand that I wasn't going to get another move, like I couldn't promote after I moved. Yeah, that's the other thing is there are some things that take up your whole turn, and so you have to do your attacks first. But then I'm always cautious. I'm like, if I do my last attack, will I be able to promote, or should I? Ego. Now I want to just keep doing this to see how high of a score we can get. Oh, nice. Oh, really? Oh, I got it done. I think I've only ever gotten above like 500 before. Whoa, 13, jeez. No, 1096.
Yeah, I'm gonna go clean the